decided to put together some trainings. These are evidence-based training modules for people who are working with people who are in crisis, who are just suffering from anxiety, from depression. And we really wanted to look at different ways of managing suicidality that have got an evidence base. We opened it up to any clinician on the Central Coast, or even people who weren't clinicians but had an interest or coming into contact with people who may be in crisis, who may be suffering from suicidality, who may be suffering from depression and anxiety, because it's not only clinicians who come into contact with those people, but it's also people within our community.
It's been really interesting seeing the approach of the Alliance, engaging business and thinking about suicide prevention in terms of kind of the workplace, and it's everybody's role, and just seeing the community pick that up.
The capacity building in the community, the training that's provided to schools, to workplaces, I think that's one of the things that has really worked well with that lifespan model.
The e-mental health workshop that we did was really interesting for me as a social worker from a professional perspective, because it gave me an opportunity to do continuing professional development that was extremely relevant to my practice, to meet others who also found that extremely relevant to the practice. So it wasn't just having somebody from the Black Dog Institute, yee-haw, come to the Central Coast and present that information. It was the opportunity to engage with like-minded other people.
And we both did the QPR, which is fantastic. And the beauty about the online stuff is we can steer people to that, as well as using it for our own resources, but for other people to engage in that, which was great.
It's less than 1 hour, it's online, it's anonymous, and you can get on there and do that training for your own well-being, to recognise signs that, you know, something might not be right in your own life, but also to be aware of what might be going on in a mate's life.
The most significant work that we were able to get out as an organisation is upskilling our staff in the workplace, and we were able to roll out the QPR training, and we found that generated a really good discussion among our staff.
We wanted to get some of our people trained up in mental health first aid, and it was at that time that we got contacted and told about this wonderful QPR training, and we thought that would be ideal. Now we've got sufficient numbers in every department across all the shifts that have been trained up. So I'm pretty comfortable that should somebody be in a situation where they're considering suicide, there is someone not far away from them at work that's done the training.
We did some assist training, not only for the Aboriginal staff that work in mental health spaces, but those that work across chronic illness, in general practice, in other spaces where they come across people that might be experiencing suicidality.
With the ATSP, the Advanced Training Suicide Prevention, we got a lot of up-to-date research on people at risk of suicide. The CAMS training provided a lot of evidence base for treatment of suicide, and it also kind of provided us with a physical tool as well. A lot of the clients really find it helpful. They say that it helps them to understand their own suicidality as well, and some of the drivers that are causing those feelings, and then we can work together on treatment for those.
We've seen this real uptake by organisations, and that's really what we wanted to see on the coast. We wanted to see the community get involved. It's a community problem that we're all facing, and how do we solve it together?